like truckers when suckers see us, they duck us. Shoot.
So we're here with Crizzly. He's playing tonight at DNA Lounge with Vital. Vital brought him here.
Yes, Vital. Shout out Vital.
Michael C. wants to know, what are your thoughts on Moombaton?
Moombaton. Yeah, I love Moombaton. Actually, I'm half Mexican.
You are?
Yes.
So what's your favorite Mexican food then?
I mean, I love migas.
You love what?
Migas.
Huh.
You never had migas?
No, I've never had migas.
You do not know what you're missing.
All right.
Yeah, it's like, I'm a big fan of breakfast food. Like, anything with syrup on it.
Really?
So like
a McGriddle, kind of?
Yeah.
Because it has syrup in the buns.
But I also like meat with my syrup, so like, an omelet is good, but migas are better.
All right.
Yeah. Love breakfast.
Me too. I love breakfast as well.
Love it.
So Ruben A. asked, what's your most memorable thing that happened to you or you experienced at shows in Denver?
Denver, yeah. Obviously, it's one of the best dubstep scenes in the country.
Really? I've never been to Denver.
Yeah. Oh, it's amazing. Yeah. Good people. A lot of good people there. I mean, every time I'm there, I'm with friends. And I remember when I played at the Ogden... You okay? Hey, cool. Someone almost died backstage. But at the Ogden, I know Protohype crowd surfed for his first time, I think. It was pretty epic. Yeah, I told him to just do it, and he did it.
Hunter asked, do you remember when you played in Melbourne, Florida last year?
I remember it. I remember it very well.
Do you have any details?
Yeah, the stage was like a high school... play. It was like trees and a forest, except better than a high school play. It was like top production. It looked like a forest. It was awesome. It was the most epic stage I've ever been on. Yeah.
Hunter wanted to know, how do you get your music to be so gangster?
Kool-Aid.
Kool-Aid. You got anything in that Kool-Aid that we should know about? Swag.
Just more Kool-Aid.
More Kool-Aid. Should we all be drinking that Kool-Aid?
Oh, yeah. I would go purple because that's my high school colors.
Purple. What high school did you go to?
Bernie High School.
Where's that?
It's in Bernie.
Where's Bernie?
It's in Texas.
Okay.
It's in the middle of nowhere.
That's, all right.
Yeah, I usually don't tell people that because it solves nothing.
What's the first event that you ever played at?
First event, my friend's quinceañera.
Hmm.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
It was hard to please the grandparents.
Oh God. What was your track selection like?
It was like AC/DC mixed with Corey Hart, Sunglasses at Night, mixed with MIA Paper Planes, mixed with some oldies songs, and the Happy Birthday song.
So with that being said, how do you classify your sound?
Well, as of now, I would say it's mostly hip-hop, a lot of bass, and a lot of crunk juice. Gotta have your crunk juice. But mostly bass and hip-hop.
Are there any records that you can't stop listening to right now?
Right now, I can't stop listening to Kendrick Lamar's new album. It's awesome. Big Gigantic actually turned me on to all his stuff. What else? I like Meek Mill. And I usually listen to trap in my free time just because I can't handle too much dubstep in my life.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been listening to that for a while. But I listen to a lot of trap and just hip hop, straight up hip hop. Pop That by French Montana. I listen to that over and over and over, especially in the shower.
Oh, do you sing in the shower?
I beatbox in the shower.
Can we hear some beatboxing?
I have to be in the shower.
All right. So maybe we'll catch that a little bit later.
Yeah, a little bit later.
Is there anything that you do to motivate the crowd while no one's dancing, or you feel like people are kind of doing their own thing?
Yeah, I usually yell in the mic to put their hands in the air. That usually works. Or just I tell them to do something, you know?
Yeah.
Just yelling on the mic usually
trying
works.
To hype them up.
You don't even have to say words. You can just...
They're like, yeah!
Yeah! And then they just do it. I don't know what they're going to do, but they do it. I had to get that out of my system.
Okay.
Oh, that felt good.
What's one city that you've never played in that you want to play in?
Pittsburgh. Because it's the only show I ever missed.
Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania?
Yeah.
I'm from Pennsylvania.
Nice.
But Pittsburgh is one place I've never been, so...
Oh, well, I've never been either, because
I
missed it.
Yeah, I could join you on that one.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm going to play there in February on my EOTO tour, so it'll be good to finally play there.
What are some other stops that tour is making excited for?
Oh, I'm excited for every single one. Yeah, first up is Boston. We're doing that soon. And yeah, all over the East Coast, so it should be good.
Do you go to the East Coast a lot?
Not too often, but I was just there with Big Gigantic.
How was it playing with them?
Awesome.
Yeah.
They're a good group of dudes. Super nice, super awesome. Saxophony, sexy sax.
Sexy sax. So when you're not partying, when you're not DJing, what do you like to do on your free time?
I'll play some Halo with my friends as of late, or I'll play Left 4 Dead, or I'll play Super Smash Brothers. 64.
Do you ever get on the mic and talk shit to anybody that you're playing with?
Nah, I mean...
That's the funnest part.
It is fun, but it's hard to do on Xbox Live on Halo. It's like, you're not really... They can't really hear you. You're not on the same team. So.
Oh, okay. I always get shot down within like 2 seconds of playing and...
I'm not good. I will admit that, but I've only had an Xbox for about 2 months now.
Okay.
Maybe less. I don't know, but I just started playing.
Do you ever use PlayStation at all?
Yeah, I have a PS3. I play Grand Theft Auto a lot. Can't wait for the new one.
Do you have a gamer tag that you want anybody to come on and play with you?
Yeah, I mean, my gamer tag's been posted up before. It's a Crizzly Bass God.
Crizzly Bass God.
Crizzly Bass God.
For anybody who wants to come play with Crizzly.
Anybody who wants to die.
So do you want to do a sign-off? You want to tell anybody what you're looking forward to?
Definitely looking forward to starting this spring tour with EOTO. They're a live band. They do all this live stuff with this crazy visual shindig on stage, but it's super dope. So I'm looking forward to starting that off next week, getting on the road. Got a lot of festivals. Can't say what yet, but I'll be around. You know, I'll get around. 2013, awesome. Gonna make a lot more music. Stoked about that. Got a nice studio set up. But yeah, excited.
Is there any remixes or collaborations we should be looking out for?
Oh, you know, I'm always about those remixes, but I got a new one coming out. I won't say much, but it should be out in a week or two. Probably two, yeah.
Okay. Well, thanks for hanging out, answering all of our questions.
It was
Facebook,
great.
Twitter.
Facebook, Twitter. Shout out Facebook. Shout out Twitter.
And can't wait to see the show tonight.
Yeah, I'm stoked. DNA Lounge, San Francisco. Here we go.
All right.
Put
bye,
your
guys.
Hands up. Put them up. If you're at home, put your hands up right now. Come on, America. We got this. Just do it. Believe. It won't be, buy it, own it. This is for my homies. Had a DJ show.